Hello friends, welcome back in my another lecture. Today I'm going to solve some problems on sample variance. This problem is actually exactly the problem that we had done in the previous lecture. The difference is only here. In the previous lecture, we had evaluated mean and standard deviation for the sample mean, and in this case we will find mean and standard deviation for the sample variances. This is the difference. The rest of things is same. So let's start. First problem is, a population consists of 5 numbers 2, 3, 6, 8 and 11. Consider all possible samples of size 2 which can be drawn with replacement. This word is important for us from this population. Find the mean of the sampling distribution of variance means mean of the sample variance and standard deviation of the sample variance. This we have to find. Mean sigma s square and mu s square. These are the two which we want to find. Right. Solution. Here, this is actually for sample drawn. Sample drawn with replacement. Sample drawn with the replacement. Since a sample consists of size 2, therefore there are 5 raised to power 2. 5 means these are the total numbers 5, and 2 means sample of size 2. So therefore there are 5 square means 25 samples of size 2 which can be drawn with the replacement, which can be drawn with the replacement. Now I am going to list all of these 25 samples of size 2 as any one of the given number on first draw can be associated with any one of the number on second draw, so various combinations of samples of size 2 are means any one of these number can be associated with another one, so we will get pair like this. This is 2, 3, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 2 also, 2, 2 as well, 2, 8, 2, 11, similarly 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 6, 3, 8, 3, 11, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 6, 6, 8, 6, 11. Next is 8, 2, 8, 3, 8, 6, 8, 8, 8, 11, and finally will be 11, 2, 11, 3, 11, 6, 11, 8, and 11, 11, because any number can be associated with any number. So combination will be like this. We have already done these types of combinations in the previous lectures. So these are the total combinations. Here the sample mean, here the sample mean x bar for each of the 25 samples are, now we want to find sample for each pair. So we find mean sum of all the number divided by total number. So these are pair. So for two, so in this case numbers are only two, x bar will be only x1 plus x2. So this is divided by 2 here, because every combination consists of sample of size 2. So there are only two numbers in that. We want to find mean, that is sample mean for each pair. So this is average of these two. Average of 2, 2 is 2, right? So 2. Average of 2, 3 is 2.5. Average of 2, 6 is 4. Continuing this way, this is 5 next. 6.5, 2.5, next is 3, next is 4.5, next is 5.5, next is 7, 4, 4.5, 6, 7, 8.5, 5, 5.5, 7, 8, 9.5, 6.5, 7, 8.5, 9.5, and final is 11, because average of these two numbers is 22, sum of these two divided by 2, 11. Similarly, 19 divided by 2 is 9.5. So these are the sample mean for each of the 25 samples. Further, since sample variance, we know sample variance is defined like this. S square, this is given like this: summation xi minus x bar whole square divided by n, right? So this is, now we want to find sample variance for each of the sample of size 2. Here for 2 2, for 2 2, S square 2 2 means x bar is 2, because for this first sample of size 2, its sample mean is 2, x bar is 2, x1, both numbers are 2 2, so x1 x2 both will be 2 2, right? And n is also 2. Substitute here, so this combination will contain only two terms. First is x1 minus 2 whole square, next is x2 minus 2 whole square divided by 2, n is also 2. Substitute the value x1 x2, this will come out to be 0. Also for next sample, next sample is 2 3. Here for 2 3, x bar is, sample mean is 2.5. here x1 is 2, first number, and x2 means second number is 3, n is again 2, because sample consists of size 2. So this is s1, so similarly s2 square will be half, x1 minus 2.5 whole square, x2 minus 2.5 whole square. Alright, substitute the value of x1 and x2 from here, and after simplification, this will come out to be 0.25, etc. So in this way, etc. means we have to find sample variances for each of these samples, 25 samples. I have evaluated sample variances for the first two samples. So continuing this way, we have to find samples for all of these. Alright. This implies corresponding sample variance for each of the 25 samples are, जैसे हमने पहले निकाला है 0, नेक्स्ट इज 0.25. इसी तरह अगर हम 2 6 का सैंपल वेरियंस निकालेंगे यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला, x1 x2 विल चेंज ओनली, राइट? सो दिस कॉम्बिनेशन विल कंटेन ओनली टू टर्म्स ऑलवेज. एंड फॉर 2 6, द सैंपल वेरियंस इज 4, x बार चेंज, x बार इज 4. सो इन दिस वे दिस विल बी 4, नेक्स्ट विल बी 9, नेक्स्ट इज 20.25, नेक्स्ट इज 0.25, नेक्स्ट जो हमारे पास आएगा 0, नेक्स्ट विल बी 2.25, नेक्स्ट आएगा 6.25, नेक्स्ट विल बी 16, नेक्स्ट विल बी 4, 2.25, 0, 1, 6.25, 9, 6.25, 1, 0, 2.25, 20.25, 16, 6.25, 2.25 and 0, right? So 0 means we have to find, 0 is the sample of the sample variance of this sample. That is, हमारे पास आएगा पहले को हम डिनोट कर एस वन स्केयर, नेक्स्ट एस टू स्केयर, कंटिन्यू इन दिस वे, लास्ट वन दिस विल बी S25 स्केयर. सो दीज आर द सैम्पल वेरियंस, सैम्पल वेरियंसिस ऑफ ऑल द सैम्पल्स, 25 सैम्पल्स, एस वन स्केयर, एस टू स्केयर, अप टू S25 स्केयर, राइट? सो दिस इज दिस वन. लेट अस फॉर दिस टू बी equation number 1. This is equation number 1. Now we will find the mean and variances therefore a part the mean of the sampling mean of the sampling distribution of variances is, इसको हम डिनोट करते हैं ई ऑफ एस स्क्वायर से, दिस इज ऑल्सो रिटन एज म्यू एस स्क्वायर, दिस विल बी सम ऑफ ऑल द सैंपल वेरियंस वेरियंसिस इन इक्वेशन वन डिवाइडेड बाय टोटल नंबर ऑफ सैंपल वेरियंसिस. टोटल नंबर ऑफ सैंपल वेरियंसिस आर 25. सम ऑफ ऑल द सैंपल वेरियंसिस इन इक्वेशन वन, इन द इक्वेशन वन इज फर्स्ट इज 0, नेक्स्ट इज 0.25, कंटिन्यू इन दिस वे, सेकंड लास्ट इज 2.25 एंड लास्ट इज 0. इफ वी ऐड ऑल ऑफ दिस, दिस विल कम आउट टू बी 135 डिवाइडेड बाय 25. This is because of equation 1. We have evaluated. This is S1 square, S2 square, S25 square. This is 5.4. Which illustrate the fact that E of S square is equal to mu S square. This by formula is n of n minus 1 upon n into sigma square. N, we know, since given numbers are 2, 3, 6, 8, 11, here x bar means summation xi divided by n. I is varying here from 1 to 5, means 2 plus 3 plus 6 up to 11 divided by 5. So this will come out to be 6, adding all of these number divided by 5, and sigma square will be, total numbers are 5, summation xi minus mu whole square. I is varying from 1 to 5. Alright. And x bar means this is equal to this is the mean, this is not x bar, this is mu. Alright, mu is 6 and x1, x2, x3, x4 is 2, 3, 6, 8, 11. This on simplification will come out to be 10.8. Alright, we had done this, these are the mean and variances of the population. We had done this in the previous lecture also in detail. You can see there also in detail. We will get, this is the mean of the population, this is the variance of the population for these given numbers. And n sample is size 2, so this is 2 minus 1 upon 2, sigma square means 10.8, so this will come out to be 5.4. So this is the experimental value of mean of the sample variances, and this is the calculated value of a mean of the sample variance. So these are exactly equal. You can see here, this is experimental value and this is the actual value. So both, so this serve as check in this calculation. So this is true. Now come to the second part. Second is B part. Variance of the sampling distribution of variances is, this is given like this, sigma square, this is S square, expected value of S square minus mu S square ka whole square, and this in summation form is total number of samples are 25 and summation Si square minus mu S square whole square and I is varying from 1 to 25, and this we evaluate. First is S1 square and mu is 5.4. You can see there mu S square, this is 5.4 whole square. Next will be S2 square minus 5.4 whole square. Continue in this way. Last will be S25 square minus 5.4 whole square bracket close. Now we will substitute the value S1 square, S2 square, S25 square from equation 1, and this will come out to be S1 square is 0, 0 minus 5.5 whole square. Next is 0.25 S2 square minus 5.4 whole square, and last is also 0, 0 minus 5.4 whole square bracket close. This is because of equation 1. I have substituted the values of S1 square, S2 square, so on up to S225, S25 square, and this one simplification will come out to be 575.75 divided by 25, and this is 23.03. So this is the variance of the sample variance. We want to find standard deviation, so this implies standard deviation of the sampling distribution of variance is, this will be written by sigma S square, this is positive square root of this one 23.03, this is 4.80. so this is what we want to find. This is the standard deviation of sampling distribution of mean sample variance, and this is the mean or expected value of the sampling distribution of the variance or a sample variance for with replacement for these five numbers. These act as like population, so these are the mean and sample variances of the population. Now come to the second question. This question is also exactly similar to previous one. Difference is only here is the word without replacement. Samples are drawn without a replacement, and rest is, this is the difference. We have this time we are going to find mean and standard deviation of the sample variance when sample is drawn without replacement. Solution for sample drawn without, or sample drawn without replacement, since sample consist of size 2, therefore because there is without replacement, so this time there will be combination, so therefore there are 5C2 which will equal to 10 samples of size 2 which can be drawn without replacement, right? That without replacement, that is, that means we draw one number and then another number which is different from the first number that we've drawn. So various combinations of samples of size 2 are this time without replacement, right? Means we draw one number and second number will be different from the previous. So this can be done in this way: 2, 3, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 11. 2, 2 is not possible there. That is 2, 3, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 11. Similarly, next will be 3, 6, 3, 8, 3, 11. Next will be 6, 8, 6, 11. And last will be 8, 11. So this will be 10 samples in all, right? The simple in layman formula, this means first number must be different from the second. Yeah, second number must be different from the first, right? There is no repetition. That's because the sample has been drawn without a replacement. Here, the sample mean x bar for each of the 10 samples are, क्या क्या होंगे आपके पास? Now we want to find sample mean for each pair. So this will be average. So this will be, we will find in this way: x1 plus x2 divided by 2 sample mean. So 2 plus 3 divided by 2, 5 by 2, 2.5, 8 by 2 is 4, right? 10 by 2 is 5. In this way, next will be 6.5, next is 4.5, next is 5.5, next is 7, next is 7, next is 8.5, and last is 9.5. 9.5 means 8 plus 11 divided by 2. So sample mean is just the average of each of these sample mean. So these are the this. Now we want to find sample variance for each of these 10 samples, right? Since sample variance s square, this is 1 upon n summation xi minus x bar whole square, right? I is varying from 1 to n. For first sample of size 2, for 2, 3, here 2, 3, for 2, 3 x bar means sample means 2.5, x1 is 2, x2 is 3, and n is 2, because sample consists of size 2. So s1 square from here will be, this is 2, x1 minus x bar, for this is 2.5 whole square, plus x2 minus 2.5 whole square. So in this equation there will be only two terms, because there is only two numbers, x1 and x2. This substitute the value of x1 and x2 from here, 2 and 3, and which on simplification this will come out to be 0.25, right? Etc. etc. means similarly we have to find sample variance for 2, 6, 2, 8, and last this will be for 8, 11, right? So this implies corresponding sample variance is for each of the 10 samples are, first we find k as 0.25. if we find sample variance for this pair 2, 6 by using this formula, this will come out to be 4. Similarly, if we find sample variance for this pair 2, 8, or this sample, this will come out to be 9. So continue in this way. Next will be 20.25, next will be 2.25, next will be 6.25, next will be 16, next will be 1, next will be 6.25, and final will be 2.25, right? So 2.25, this is for, this is sample variance for this sample 811, right? Using this formula, that is पहला गया हमारे पास एस वन स्केयर, नेक्स्ट इज एस टू स्केयर, कंटिन्यू इन दिस वे, लास्ट वन दिस वन इज एस टेन स्केयर. सो दीज आर द वन नाउ ए पार्ट. ए पार्ट इज मीन ऑफ द सैम्पलिंग डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मीन, देयरफॉर मीन ऑफ द सैम्पलिंग डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन of variance is, this will be E of S square, which is equal to mu S square, sum of all the sample variances in equation 1 divided by total number of sample variances. Total number of sample variances are 10. So sum of all these means 0.25 plus 4 plus so on continue. Last is 2.25. Since of using equation 1, if we simplify this one, this will come out to be 67.5 divided by 10. So this is 6.75. This is the mean of the sample variance or mean or expected value of the sample in distribution of a variance. Since for given number 2, 3, 6, 8, 11, mu means sum of all this number divided by n, sum of all this number and these numbers are 25. If we find mean for this one, this will come out to be, n in this case is 5, right? So this will come out to be 6, and variance, this will be summation xi minus mu whole square divided by 5. I is varying from 1 to 5 for this number, and this will come out to be 10.8. right? And sample consists of size 2, right? Therefore, which means the mean or expected value of sample variance that we have evaluated just, which illustrate the fact that E of S square is equal to mu S square, this will equal to n upon n minus 1, n minus 1 upon n sigma square. This is the formula for mean or expected value for sample variance in case population is finite and sample is without a replacement. Here size of the population is 5 because 5 numbers are given and sample consists of size 2. So this is 5 upon 5 minus 1, 2 minus 1 upon 2. Sigma square means 10.8, right? And this on simplification will come out to be 6.75. And this is the experimental value of mean or expected value sample variance. And this is exactly equal to the calculated value because the calculated value is also 6.75. So this serves as check in the previous calculation that we have evaluated, right? Now B part, variance of the sampling distribution of variances is, this is sigma square S square, expected value of S square minus mu S whole square, this is by formula. And this in summation form, total number of samples are 10. Summation I is varying from 1 to 10. S I square minus mu S square whole square. Now opening this 1 upon 10. First term will be S1 square and mu is 6.25. This one 6.75. this one. Second term will be s2 square minus 6.75 whole square. Continue in this way. Last term will be s10 whole square minus 6.75 whole square, bracket close. Now 1 upon 10, substitute the value of s1 since of equation 1. S1 is 0.25 minus 6.75. S2 is 4, this is 4 minus 6.75, and this one continue. S10 square, this is 2.25 minus 6.75 whole square, bracket close. This is because of equation 1. In equation 1 we have evaluated as these sample variances, first sample variance, second sample variance, and this is 10th sample variance, and which on simplification will come out to be 396.75 divided by 10, so this is 39.675. so this is the variance of the sample variance. So this implies standard deviation of the sampling distribution of variances is, and this will be positive square root of this 39.675, and this will come out to be 6.298. if we round off this two decimal place, this will come out to be 6.30. so this is the standard deviation of sampling distribution of variance or sample variance, and this is the mean or expected value of a sample variance, right? This is without replacement, must remember. So friends, in this lecture we have learned about how to find mean or expected value for sample variance with replacement, without replacement, then variance of the sample variance followed by standard deviation of the sample variance with replacement and without replacement, right? So this is all about this lecture. Thank you.